We've just learned U.S. Marshals have once again increased the reward to find a Texas prison escapee.
And now it's up to $30,000 for anyone who can help end this manhunt.
Meanwhile, today we uncovered some surprising court documents about Arcade Comeaux's disabilities.
Supposedly, he was using a wheelchair at the time of his escape.
This happened Monday morning as two guards were moving him from Huntsville to the Stiles unit in Beaumont. They were in a prison van in Conroe when Comeaux made his move. 11 News reporter Sherman Chow is in the newsroom with how he apparently tried to con officials with his disability. Sherman?
Now, Lucy, if so, it was an elaborate plan. UTMB, which provides medical care for inmates, has now begun its own internal review. Meantime, we've obtained a copy of a federal lawsuit Comeaux filed in 2007 over his disabilities and the judge's response. Before Comeaux's escape from a medical transport prison vehicle, he tried another kind of escape through the legal system. The convicted child rapist had filed a federal lawsuit saying TDCJ violated his civil rights because of his disabilities. Comeaux, in and out of prison for 30 years, claimed a stroke left him partially paralyzed, that he could not ambulate or walk, and was doubly incontinent. But court records show as far back as 1999, a doctor noted, quote, he stood and walked with a normal gait, and implies that Comeaux has exaggerated the extent of his paralysis and that he is malingering.
He stabbed me in the chest.
That is the same year he attacked his wife during a contact prison visit with a 12-inch rod fashioned from a bucket handle.
He got up and was telling somebody that he got up out the chair and walked.
Comeaux insisted on using diapers and wanted a transfer from the Estelle High Security Unit, which he claimed did not meet his wheelchair needs. But the judge noted TDCJ provided surveillance video showing Comeaux taking good care of himself in his cell and able to rise from his chair and stand unassisted. TDCJ contracts with the University of Texas Medical Branch to provide doctors and medical services. Inmates would typically see the same medical personnel. UTMB's Vice President of Correctional Managed Care tells us it is now, quote, certainly looking into all the details relating to the clinical care in this case. We asked if an inmate could fake a condition such as paralysis for a decade. Dr. Murray says it would be, quote, surprising and required someone, quote, extremely dedicated. In 2001, a medical evaluation noted Comeaux had normal muscle tone of lower and upper extremity. And last year, U.S. District Judge John Rainey dismissed Comeaux's case with prejudice. We are told that inmates will exaggerate physical and mental disabilities to get out of work and into air conditioning. Prison officials repeat that the wheelchair and disability assignments are UTMB questions. The smuggled gun used in the escape is a prison question. Live from the newsroom, Sherman Chow, 11 News.